Hello everyone, welcome or welcome back to my channel. So friends, this is the third video of the English explanation of 120 rules of English grammar. But before starting the video, let me give you some information. I will provide the PDFs of every rule PPT. If you want to get those PDFs, join the Telegram channel. I will provide the link in the description box, friends. So that's being said, let's get into the video. So today we are going to discuss about the third rule, and the rule is about the usage of who and whom. So friends, who and whom are two words that are used to represent subjects and objects, or else subjective pronouns and objective pronouns. If we discuss the individual usage of these two, who is particularly used to represent subjective pronouns. And if you have completed your grammar rules, you will automatically know that subjective pronouns are he, she, it, they, we, I, and you. Whereas whom is used to represent objective pronouns. And the objective pronouns are him, her, it, them, you, me, and us. To let you understand, I also gave an example here. You can see the example sentence. He saw him. Here, the sentence is complete with three perfect parts of speech. He acts as an subject, saw acts as an verb, and whereas him acts as an object. Here, he and him are pronouns that are used instead of subjective and objective nouns. And always remember that the noun or pronoun which comes before verb is always a subject or subjective pronoun, and the noun or pronoun that comes always after the verb is a objective noun or objective pronoun. Now you understood the difference between the subjective pronoun and objective pronoun. You can understand the concept that who is used to represent subjective pronoun and whom is used to represent objective pronoun. And next, in order to understand the concept of error questions that will be asked based on who and whom, you need to first understand the concept of answering to the questions based on who and whom. So now let's understand this concept of answering questions to who and whom. As you can see here, the first example, if a question is asked using who, it will be as shown in the first one. Like for example, who is your father? Then the answer might be, if we represent him using a name, then we can say Chetan is my father. But if we are using a pronoun, then we will say he is my father. So here you can see that instead of using the noun, we just used here the pronoun he. So in this way, you can say that he is a subjective pronoun, and we will use who in order to represent these subjective pronouns. This concept is also same for the pronoun whom also. So in order to understand this, let us see at the example two. So if we want to ask any question using the word whom, then we will ask like this, as shown in the second example, that is, whom did they arrest yesterday? Then if we represent the person with a name, then the answer will be like, for example, they arrested Chandan. But if we want to represent the person with the pronoun, then we will say that they arrested him. Here you can see that him is used as a pronoun instead of objective noun, and whom is used to represent that particular objective pronoun. So in this way, we can understand the concept that who is used to represent subjective pronouns and whom is used to represent objective pronouns. If you understood this concept, then you can easily answer the error questions based on the pronouns who and whom. Now let us say some examples related to who and whom, which can be asked as error questions in our examination. In the first example, you can see that she met the person blank says that I am caught. We need to fill up the blank. I also gave you answers in the form of red colored words who and whom. Here we can say that the sentence I am caught represents I, a subjective pronoun. So in order to represent that, we will use the word who in the place of the blank. So the answer will be she met the person who says that I am caught. In the second sentence, we can see the sentence is she met the person dash got likes. Here, if we answer the question, then we will say that God likes him. Here, him is a objective pronoun. So in order to represent this objective pronoun, we need to use the pronoun whom. So that's why the answer is whom. She met the person whom God likes. Here I gave third and fourth examples in order to let you understand the concept that who is used for subjective pronouns and whom is used for objective pronouns. Now we will see the fifth example. The fifth example says that she saw her dash I think is a rock star. If we ask the question who is a rock star, we can say he or she is a rock star. So here he or she represent subjective pronoun. So in order to replace this subjective pronoun, we use here who. So the final answer will be she saw her who I think is a rock star. And then in the sixth example, we can see the sentence that they met them dash they say works very hard. Here, if we answer the question who works very hard, then we can say he works very hard. So here he is the subjective pronoun. So in order to represent that subjective pronoun, we use who in place of the blank. So the final answer will be they met them who they say works very hard. And then in the seventh example, we can see the sentence that she met him dash I think was arrested yesterday. So if we answer the question who was arrested yesterday, then we will answer like he was arrested yesterday. So here he represents subjective pronoun. So in order to represent this subjective pronoun, we will use the pronoun who in place of the blank. So the answer will be she met him who I think was arrested yesterday. Next to the eighth example, we can see the sentence that she met him dash the police arrested yesterday. Here, if we want to answer the question, whom did the police arrested yesterday, then we will obviously give the answer as the police arrested him. So here, him is a subjective, sorry, objective pronoun. So in order to represent this objective pronoun, we will use whom in the blank. So the final answer will be, she met him whom the police arrested yesterday. So friends, if you understood this concept, then you can easily answer the error questions based on who and whom, because we know that who is used to represent subjective pronouns and whom is used to represent objective pronouns. And one final thing you need to always keep in your mind is that who and whom are only used for human beings and domestic animals, but not any things or wild animals. Here you can see, for example, if we take human beings, the subjective pronouns are he, she, they, you and I, and for them we will use who as the representing pronoun. And for objective pronouns like him, her, them, you and we will use whom in order to represent the objective pronouns. Whereas for domestic animals, the subjective pronoun will be it and we will use who for that. And the objective pronoun also will be it and we will use whom for that. So this is the final thing you need to keep in your mind. And you can not use who and whom for any other things which are lifeless. So friends, this is all about this concept of who and whom. So friends, I understood this concept in this way and I am sure that I gave the clear-cut explanation for you also to make understand this concept. But if you have any doubts regarding to it, let me know in the comment section, friends. Friends, I gave the exact explanation and example as given by the Nimisha ma'am, because you should not be confused when you go through the Nimisha ma'am's videos and when you compare my videos to ma'am's videos, so that I gave everything as said by ma'am. So I hope that you understood the concept. So friends, finally, if you find the video useful to you, please do like the video and also share it to your friends who are in need of it. Please do share the video, friends, because it will help me and also others who are in need of it. And also friends, don't forget to subscribe to my channel, and I will meet you in the next video with another rule. Until then, bye bye, take care.